According to Salvatore Abigaba, the Kabarore District Production Officer, temperature rise leads to more heat waves, drought, floods, cyclones, wildfires, pests and diseases. The unpredictable weather conditions make it difficult for farmers to grow food.
So prediction of weather patterns is important so that farmers determine when to plant and when to harvest.
These diseases and pests have also changed by seasons, affecting crops, causing food insecurity. We are, for example, seeing now the banana rust thrips, where in the market you're seeing these brown bananas.
Abigaba says to overcome this challenge, farmers need to adopt the use of efficient irrigation systems, growing improved crop varieties and breeds that can resist the unpredictable weather conditions.
Species of plants and animals that can survive under this given environment, that can tolerate high temperatures, that are drought resistant, and then at the same time we are of course moving to using more of our artificial interventions.
Bernard Bwambale, a farmer, says that there is need for government and its partners to invest in water harvesting and agroforestry schemes and also sensitize farmers on urban farming.
Currently, if we try to have agroforestry, now this time we're not talking about planting trees, any trees, we can talk about agroforestry. Like you're planting your fruits on the sides of your garden, so you're providing a double thing. You're providing food, but also you're providing a tree that is going to work for, you know, to mitigate issues of weather changes and all that.
Richard Rabuhinga, the Kabarore District Chairman, explains that negative effects of climate change are induced by man activities. He adds that there is need to protect nature and environment by the people if they are to overcome the crisis.
Is that we should come up to protect nature, we should come up to protect the environment, we should implement the laws available as local governments and other actors, without, in a universal way.
Recently, parts of Mbale, Kasese and Ntoroko districts were hit by floods and landslides, and other parts in western Uganda, including Kabarore, Yibanda, Mbarara, Rampala, Bunyangabu districts, hit by hailstorms that left gardens of food and more farms and homesteads destroyed.
Because we have had heavy hailstorms, destroying livestock, destroying homes, destroying crops in gardens, and as a result, leaving the district very insecure.
Report compiled by Doreen Nasima for the news.